you're going to tell me, no, I can assure you that preventive care will not include abortion. I'd like to know if you're not going to vote for that amendment, how would you prevent it from doing it?
Thank you. I think there's two questions in there. The first two are yes and yes. There is absolutely no rationale in it. And to your point, this one, I do feel very, very strongly about, to stamp out any type of misleading information that's out there, that there's any type in here of anything that even touches upon what some might call rationing of care at the zero. I can assure you about 150%. Well, you've got two parents who are 80-some years old, and I want them to live forever. If I could say, there is nothing in there on it. I don't know anything about whatever you're talking about, but I can assure you there is nothing in there on it.
Instead of myself and my patients deciding what care they need, I have to check with the government whether it's going to be covered.
I see the point. The problem we have today in the healthcare plans is, as we sit this moment, is there is rationing. That's the problem. The insurance company says to you, hey, I'm sorry, I can't do you if you used to have cancer when you were 4 years old. I know you're 18 now, but I've rationed it for you. Stop. Zippo. No rationing. We do say, however, that there's a floor under which that you've got to provide at least this. We say, and almost all of it is preventive care. We want a senior to get, when they get to 65, a free, no copay glaucoma. Why? Because one out of every five seniors over the age of 80 is legally blind. Because they don't get treatment for glaucoma. So by the time they get to 80, they're legally blind, their quality of life goes by. We have to take care of them more because you have to lead them around. And so we say, well, 65 years old, free glaucoma exam, and want to find out. Oh, by the way, no payment for bone density exam. Copay. Why? We want to find out at 65 as you begin upon the twilight of life, so to speak. That let's make sure that we take care of and make sure you get that medicine for the bones, because you fall down, weak bones, big infection, if something happens, we pay more, and your quality of life is less. So we don't ration anything, we make it better, more accessible, etc. To your last question, I did not vote for that amendment. I think the amendment you're talking about is the one in the Energy and Commerce Committee, and I just want to double check that, where it was voted into the bill that forbade any public funding for abortions. For an abortion. And that's an impact.